A thick set of wheels is what separates the gym bros who neglect them from the guys with the most aesthetic and complete physiques. If you thought squats were the king of lower body exercises, I wouldn't argue with you. But how do you add muscle mass to your legs when all you have is a dumbbell? I can tell you now, if you do leg workouts how most people do them, you'll just be burning a few calories and breaking a sweat at best. At worst, you'll shrink your legs. But when you follow the science-based advice and workout in this video, you can feel confident that you are getting an effective leg workout using dumbbells. Just dumbbells. I'll break down exactly why I chose each exercise and explain them step by step so you can build strong, athletic legs that pop instead of boyish twigs that you have to hide behind sweatpants. Before we get into the workout, here's a quick tip. Usually, I'd recommend sticking mostly to the 6 to 15 rep range and leaving 1 to 2 reps in the tank for most exercises. That's because tons of studies and meta-analysis like this one by Schoenfeld and colleagues suggest that we can build muscle equally as well with weights greater than 60% 1 rep max and less than 60% of 1 rep max. There are just a few caveats that are vital for your dumbbell workouts. When the load is light, think 15 or more reps. The weight isn't heavy enough to stimulate all your muscle fibers like the fast twitch type 2 fibers that require significant resistance to hit the threshold to be activated. Only when you take these high rep sets to complete failure does muscle growth become equally effective as moderate and heavy rep ranges. I'm telling you this because if you're working with limited dumbbells that are too light, especially for a leg workout which usually requires very heavy weight, then you'd be wise to do higher reps than the indicated rep ranges and take the set to complete failure. Now let's get into the workout. Exercise number 1, Bulgarian split squats, 4x10. You're probably used to starting off your leg workout with heavy barbell back squats. That's definitely a solid plan. Now we just need a heavy compound movement to stimulate the quads as effectively as squats do. Considering you can't put a heavy barbell on your back during this workout, using one leg at a time is a simple way to significantly increase demands on your legs without heavier weight, and definitely works. Research published in the International Journal of Exercise Science compared back squats, Bulgarian split squats, and split squats. They surprisingly found no difference in muscle activation between the exercises. The only difference was that a hamstring muscle, the biceps femoris, experienced greater activation. On T Nation, Dr. Brett Contreras said these findings are similar to his own experiments. He claims that having the back leg raised raises stability demands, leading to increased hamstring, glute, as well as hip flexor activity. With all that being said, there is a way to emphasize different muscles. With a longer stance, the front knee travels forward less and the hamstring and glute contraction will be greater. But if you want more quad activation, you can keep a shorter stance so that you're more upright and there's a bit more forward knee travel. You can pick whatever stance you prefer based on what weak points you have. Exercise number 2, dumbbell RDL, 4x10. A good option for the hamstrings and glutes would be a hip hinge, like a deadlift or similar variant like the Romanian deadlift. In this case, we'll opt for the dumbbell Romanian deadlift. I have two variations for you, which I'll show you in a moment. A study published in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research compared the glute ham raise, good morning, leg curl, and RDL. The RDL and glute ham raise produced significantly more activation than the other exercises. While the glute ham raise was the best for the concentric portion, the Romanian deadlift had the greatest eccentric muscle activation, which is the contraction as you lower the weight. The Romanian deadlift is a good option, but what do you do if the dumbbells just aren't heavy enough? For example, if you do barbell RDLs with 225 pounds, you likely won't have heavy enough dumbbells. That's why, if needed, you can substitute this with a single leg dumbbell Romanian deadlift. Like with the Bulgarian split squat, using just one leg increases the demands of your muscles without requiring you to find heavier weight. If you do have trouble balancing, you can use a staggered stance instead of keeping your back leg in line with your back. Exercise number 3, dumbbell front squat 4x15. Usually people will say that the back squat works more glutes and hamstrings, and the front squat works more quads. This isn't totally wrong, but research doesn't exactly support it. A study in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research compared the front squat and back squat. The overall muscle activation was actually the same. The only difference was that the front squat led to less compressive forces on the knees. So if knee pain is an issue, front squats could be a good idea. Goblet squats would be a great option too, but only with one dumbbell. Your core or even arms will fatigue before your quads. By doing a dumbbell front squat with a dumbbell on each shoulder, you can almost exclusively focus on your quad activation. A common issue is that lifters will feel the bar or dumbbells in this case dropping in front of them. While most guys think this is a strength issue, it's more to do with mobility. Your thoracic spine or your mid-back has to remain extended. Just imagine trying to hold up weights in front of you with a rounded back. There's no way you can hold up even a lightweight. Here's a simple thoracic mobility exercise you can do as part of your warm-up. The first is a thoracic spine extension over a foam roller. Place the foam roller under your mid-back and extend your arms overhead. You can roll back and forth over your T-spine to mobilize the region. It significantly helps to hold onto dumbbells with your hands to create a bigger stretch. Do this for about 1 minute. You might also feel like you can't squat lower, or maybe your heels lift up. Since there's a bit more ankle mobility required compared to a back squat, you can do some ankle mobility work too. Here's a simple drill you can do in the warm-up. Just loop a band behind the ankles so the band pulls your lower leg back. If you don't have a band, it's no problem. You can get in the same position and use your forearm to push your front leg down and get a stretch in the calves. This will help with ankle mobility in a similar way. Exercise number 4, dumbbell leg curl 4x15. The dumbbell Romanian lift will hit your hamstrings and glutes hard, but for complete hamstring development, you'll need a little bit more. 2015 research published in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research found that there's a regional activation in your hamstrings. The stiff leg deadlift emphasized the upper hamstrings. However, a leg curl movement is needed to emphasize the lower hamstrings. In fact, part of the hamstring can't even be activated with stiff leg deadlifts. The biceps femoris of the hamstring has two heads, the short head and the long head. While the long head is biarticular and crosses the hip and knee, the short head only crosses the knee. So if you want to hit that bicep femoris short head, you must do leg curls. According to research from Central Queensland University, the eccentric strength of hamstring curls are most important for preventing knee injuries in athletes as well as sports performance. That's why you should slowly lower the dumbbell under control. Don't feel it in your hamstrings. A big mistake is arching the lower back. Slightly squeeze the glutes and contract your core to focus on using the hamstrings rather than the low back. Exercise number 5, one leg dumbbell hip thrust, superset with slow eccentric sumo squat 3x12. All that's left to emphasize are the glutes. They're necessary to have proper posture, prevent injury, and have an attractive aesthetic physique. Believe it or not, the glutes are also one of the strongest muscles in your body. If all we did was use a light dumbbell, we'd likely give up out of sheer boredom before the glutes fatigue. That's why we'll be doing one leg dumbbell hip thrusts. An Australian research team compared the back squat, Romanian deadlift, and barbell hip thrust. The hip thrust activated the glutes the most. It shouldn't be too surprising because the top of the hip thrust is when the glutes are emitting the most force. It's also when they're under the most resistance because your glutes are thrusting directly against the force of gravity. It can be a bit awkward at first when setting up. I suggest you choose a low platform or try to find a bench that's a little lower to the floor. Place the platform directly under your scapula so they rest on top of the platform. You'll have to experiment with the distance of your front foot, but doing it so that your lower leg is roughly perpendicular with the floor is a good starting point. After doing one set for each leg, immediately switch to slow eccentric sumo squats. This superset makes sure your glutes are torched with max metabolic stress. It's a lot like a sumo deadlift, which is shown to be a powerful movement for the quads and glutes. We slow down the eccentric for a few reasons. 1, you probably don't have a heavy enough weight to add significant tension to your glutes. 2, a longer rep duration helps elicit greater tension and metabolic stress for a pump. And 3, it helps make eccentric contraction even more effective. Like I hinted at, the eccentric contraction may be even more important than the concentric or lifting portion. Research from Lehman College showed that eccentric exercise led to a 10% increase in muscle growth, while concentric only led to a 6.8% increase. When you combine the metabolic stress from the superset with the muscle damage of the slow eccentric sumo squats, you have a serious glute finisher signaling for muscle growth. That is the best scientific-based leg workout using only dumbbells. For your convenience, here's a summary of the workout. Just remember to use heavy enough weight or do extra reps until each set is in the proximity of failure, or all the way to failure if doing sets above 15 reps. Follow this dumbbell-only leg workout and you will experience complete lower body development and add slabs of muscle mass even with such limited equipment. Did you find this video helpful? If so, click the like button below as it'll truly help out the channel. Also, if your training and nutrition are in order and you're looking for a bit of an edge, be sure to check out my science-based supplement line. Each product was created using scientifically proven ingredients, all clinically dosed and guaranteed to produce results. And right now, you can get 25% off your entire order, plus free shipping by using the coupon code MONSTER at checkout. So head over to musclemonsters.com/supplements or click the link in the description. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe for more videos. And don't forget to turn on post notifications so you don't miss the next one. Peace.